When thinking about the best running backs in college football, there are a number of names that come to mind. Najee Harris, Travis Etienne, Breece Hall, Kyren Williams, and many others. However, there's one name you probably don't think of, but it's one you really need to add to the list of best running backs in college football. That's Jaret Patterson from Buffalo. Not only is he the best running back in the MAC, he's making a case that he's the best running back in the entire country. Before we get to today's video, make sure you click that subscribe button and turn on those notifications so you never miss another video. If you love college football, this is definitely the channel for you. Jaret Patterson took the college football world by storm on Saturday and became more of a household name. He tied Howard Griffin's FBS record for rushing touchdowns in a game with 8, recorded the second highest single game rushing yards total of 408 yards, and joined Ricky Williams as the only players in FBS history with back-to-back 300-yard rushing games. So, who exactly is Jaret Patterson and where did he come from? Well, if you've been around my channel for a few years, Jaret Patterson should be a name you already recognize. He's reached out to me and asked me to make him a highlight video 2 years in a row, and I was honored to have him as a guest on the Harris Highlight Show back in February. If you'd like to listen to my full interview with Patterson, I'll post a link to that in the description of this video. At 5'9" and less than 200 pounds, Jaret Patterson isn't your prototypical running back. He's undersized, and that really hurt him while being recruited. Jaret has a twin brother, James, who currently plays linebacker at Buffalo too. As one can imagine, they were inseparable as brothers while growing up. They did everything together, including playing football. When they'd create themselves in Madden or the NCAA football video game, they were on the same team. If you would have seen the way they carried themselves when college coaches came in, James would tell them straight up, "I'm playing with my brother," and vice versa, said Justin Winters, an assistant coach at their high school. They let it be known, "We're playing together, so if you don't want my brother, you might as well not even recruit me." That's how they were going the whole time. I'd never seen it like that in the recruiting process. They told them what they wanted to do. Both brothers had a lifelong dream of playing college football together, but the only problem was James was receiving more attention than his brother Jaret, so it was beginning to look unlikely they'd both end up at the same school. Jaret got only 5 FBS offers: Toledo, Kent State, Eastern Michigan, Air Force, and Navy. James had more, but not as many as he could have had. He said that his brother James lost quite a few offers because some bigger schools didn't want to offer Jaret. One school that the brothers knew a lot about was Buffalo. Winters, their assistant coach, was a Buffalo linebacker from 2007 to 2010, and he gave a lot of his old apparel to the Patterson boys and his other players. Buffalo offered James as a sophomore and offered Jaret as a junior. They committed before their senior year in 2016, but there was a catch in their commitment. Buffalo already had a running back commit in Kevin Marks, so Buffalo coaches asked Jaret to gray shirt, which meant instead of joining the Bulls on schedule in 2017, he would enroll in January 2018, technically being a part of the next recruiting class. The request was for Jaret, but not James. But once again, James demanded he and Jaret stay together, so he decided to gray shirt as well. Instead of spending their first year out of high school at Buffalo, they were back at their high school, helping Winters and the staff as volunteer coaches and working out on their own while they waited a year to play at Buffalo. "It wouldn't be right to have that dream without him," James said. "That's a dream I always wanted to share with my brother." Meanwhile, Jaret went out and had himself an incredible senior campaign. He rushed for over 2,000 yards with 23 rushing touchdowns. His best game that season was something out of a video game when he accounted for a total of 558 all-purpose yards. He was named an All-State honorable mention. As a freshman, Jaret Patterson quickly won over the entire coaching staff along with the entire Buffalo fan base. He was named the MAC Freshman of the Year and an All-MAC second team while leading the team in rushing with 1,013 rushing yards. He also added 14 touchdowns on the season as well, both school records for a freshman running back. He averaged 5.5 yards per carry, which was the third most in school history for a single season. How did Patterson follow up his historic freshman campaign? By having arguably the greatest season by a Bulls running back in program history. He rushed for a single season school record 1,799 yards and scored 19 rushing touchdowns, also a school record. He led the MAC and ranked 5th in the nation in rushing. Patterson was named All-MAC First Team and was named the Walter Camp National Player of the Week after rushing for a single game school record 298 yards and a MAC record 6 touchdowns against Bowling Green on November 29th of 2019. He had 7 games in which he rushed for at least 140 yards and 5 games in which he had at least 2 rushing touchdowns. Over his final 6 games of 2019, he rushed for 1,113 yards with 15 touchdowns. Over the last month of the season, he was the best running back in college football. As Patterson told me when I talked to him in February, this was expected to be a big season for Buffalo. Expectations were high entering 2020 as they'd be making a push at winning the MAC, but then the pandemic put the season on hold. The MAC was the first conference to postpone fall sports in August. Jaret was disappointed by the news, but understood. He decided to speak out, publicly campaigning for the MAC to reverse its decision. He didn't let up, becoming the most prominent figure in the league to speak publicly. Here's what he tweeted back in September. "I'm happy for my brothers in the Big Ten who'll get to play this season, but it's been over a month since we canceled our football football season. The reason most of us have worked so hard in our lives, gone. The reason a lot of us were even able to go to college, gone. And now, 70% of college football is playing. I know we don't have $100 million budgets in the MAC, and we're not going to win a national championship, but if it's not about money, why can't we play? The guys that are playing don't work harder than us. They don't care more than us. Why can't we play? Respectfully, we deserve to have answers as to why we can't do it safely when all these other places can. Ultimately, the MAC ended up returning to action, and Patterson has been unstoppable since his first snap of 2020. In just four games, the junior running back has already rushed for 920 yards, averaging 8.6 yards per carry. His 920 rushing yards are the fifth most in the FBS already. He also has 16 rushing touchdowns, trailing Najee Harris by only one for the lead in the FBS. Oh, did I mention again he's only played in four games? His first two games were pretty uneventful as he rushed for just over 200 yards with four rushing touchdowns. His last two games are where he's gone into complete video game mode, putting together arguably the greatest two-game stretch from a running back in college football history. On November 17th against Bowling Green, Patterson rushed for a school record 301 yards with four rushing touchdowns. Patterson broke his previous record of 298 yards on the ground that he set against Bowling Green last year. Well, his record of 301 yards didn't last long at all. This past weekend, Jaret Patterson was named the Walter Camp Foundation Football Bowl Subdivision National Offensive Player of the Week, following what, in my opinion, was the greatest rushing performance we've ever seen. He rushed for 409 yards, the second most in FBS history, while he also tied an FBS record with 8 rushing touchdowns. Patterson averaged 11.8 yards per carry and had 4 touchdowns of 30 or more yards, as the Bulls improved to 4-0 with the victory. Jaret Patterson's 710 rushing yards over the last 2 weeks are the most in a 2-game span in FBS history. As I mentioned earlier in this video, he's also the second player ever to rush for 300 plus yards in back-to-back games, joining Ricky Williams, who did it in 1998. Buffalo is now undefeated on the season, and they look like they're the team to beat in the MAC. As of the time of recording this video, the Bulls aren't ranked in the top 25, but I wouldn't be surprised if they were at some point in the coming weeks. Jaret Patterson has now played in 30 games during his collegiate career, and his numbers are truly remarkable. He's rushed for over 3,700 yards, averaging more than 6 yards a carry, while having 49 rushing touchdowns. It may be too little too late, but what Jaret Patterson is doing should definitely put him in at least the Heisman top 10 conversation. As I mentioned earlier, he's already top 5 in rushing yards, and top 2 in rushing touchdowns. Sadly, Buffalo only has 2 more games this season, so that really could hurt his chances, but he definitely should at least receive some votes for what he's doing. I'm not entirely sure what Jaret Patterson plans on doing once the season ends. There are definitely a handful of running backs who will be drafted before him, but his stock has definitely risen in the last month. If he were to return for his senior season, Patterson will not only shatter every Buffalo record there is, he could potentially come close to breaking some NCAA records as well, but we're just gonna have to wait and see. Let me know what your guys' thoughts are on Jaret Patterson down below. Do you guys think his game from this past weekend is the greatest rushing performance in college football history? Also, share with me whether or not you think he deserves to receive Heisman votes, even though he's only gonna play a total of 6 games. If you guys could please take a second and give this video a thumbs up, I would greatly appreciate it. And don't forget to smash that subscribe button if you haven't done so yet. I post a ton of college football content here, so if you love college football, this is definitely the place for you. As always, thank you guys so much for watching, and I'll see you all very soon.